बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, वेलकम टू अलमुनीर हाई स्कूल ई लर्निंग सिस्टम क्लास 4। दिस इज़ योर साइंस क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर यूनिट नंबर 9। टॉपिक इज स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। दिस इज़ द टाइटल पेज ऑफ योर अमेजिंग साइंस बुक फॉर क्लास 4। टॉपिक इज स्टैटिक इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। Rubbing materials together produces static electricity. Static electricity. Everything on earth is made up of atoms. The nucleus of an atom contains protons. Protons have a positive charge on it. Around the nucleus are particles called electrons. Electrons have a negative charge on it. The number of protons and electrons is equal. Therefore, atoms are neutral. When we rub a plastic ruler with a piece of cloth, the ruler pulls electrons from the cloth. This gives it a negative charge. The cloth becomes positively charged because it has lost electrons. Materials that gain electrons have a negative charge. Materials that lose electrons have a positive charge on it. Electricity which is not moving is called static electricity. It stays in one place. Static electricity is produced by rubbing materials together. Rubbing gives the materials an electric charge. Electrostatic induction. A positively charged object will attract or pull a negatively charged object, but objects having the same charge will repel or push each other as shown in this figure. If a charged object is brought close to a neutral object, it will produce an opposite charge. This process is called induction. Clothes made from man-made fibers such as nylon and twine build up charges very quickly when they are rubbed and can even produce sparks. Test for the presence of a charge. A charged object will attract neutral objects, for example, a rubber balloon will become charged if it is rubbed against a woolen shirt, and it will stick to a wall when brought close to it. A body can be tested for a charge in the laboratory with the help of an instrument called a gold leaf electroscope. Here we have the picture of gold leaf electroscope. A gold leaf electroscope consists of two gold foil leaves attached to a metal ball by a rod. These are enclosed in a glass case. If a charged body is brought close to the neutral metal ball of the electroscope, the gold leaves repel each other because an opposite charge has been induced in them and they have a similar charge. Electrostatic induction in nature. Lightning. Clouds become charged when tiny water droplets or crystals of ice present in the clouds rub against each other. When they become highly charged, a large number of electrons jump from one cloud to another to form a cloud to the earth in the form of a stream. This flow of electrons produces a flash of lightning as shown in this picture. Lightning conductors. In order to protect a high building from damage due to lightning, a pointed metallic rod called a lightning conductor is fixed to its highest point. This repels any charges that may be induced in the building from the clouds. Next, we have the concept of current electricity. An electric current is a pathway along which charged particles can flow as shown in this picture, an electric circuit. The cell is a source of energy. Here we have the cell, which is a source of energy which pushes the charge in the circuit like this. It is connected to a bulb by wires made of metal. These wires let charge pass along them. There is a complete path from the positive end of the cell to the negative end. An electric circuit must have a complete conducting pathway. If there are any gaps, the charge cannot flow. What is switch? An electric current can be turned on and off by a switch. The switch forms a bridge in the path of the flow of electricity. When you turn the switch on, a small metal piece inside the switch completes the circuit and the current flows along the wires. When you turn the switch off, the metal piece moves away from the wire and the electric current stops flowing. So here we have the picture of this switch. Conductors and insulators, materials that allow an electric charge to pass along them, are called conductors. Metals are good conductors of electricity. In conductors, some electrons are not very tightly held to their atoms. They can move through the material by passing from atom to atom when pushed by an energy source. Materials that do not allow an electric charge to pass along them are called insulators. In insulators, the electrons are all tightly held to the atoms, so they cannot move through the materials even when pushed. Plastic, rubber, wood, and PVC, polyvinyl chloride are insulators. Electric wires are made up of conductors. The handles and bodies of electrical appliances are made up of conductors. Next, students, we have these activities. Pull a plastic comb through your hair many times and then hold it close to a piece of paper. What do you observe? Can you explain this? Rub an inflated rubber balloon on a woolen jersey. Hold the balloon against a wall. What do you observe? What does this demonstrate about a charged body and a neutral body? Rub two plastic rulers with a dry cloth and hang them close to each other by threads. Do the rulers swing towards or away from each other? Rub a glass rod with a silk cloth and plastic ruler with a woolen cloth. Hang the rulers close to each other by threads. What do you observe? All these things attract or repel with each other. To test whether a material is a conductor or insulator, you will need three pieces of plastic coated wire, 20 centimeters long, a small battery, small bulb, some objects such as toothbrush, pen, ruler, nail, fork, and coin. Join the wires to the bulb and battery as shown in this diagram. Touch together the loose ends of the wires to test that the bulb lights up when the circuit is complete. Test each material by placing one wire at each end of the object and observe whether or not the bulb lights up. Record which materials are conductors and which are insulators. Fill it according to your observations. Next, students, we have the solved exercise of lesson number 9. Question number 1, answer the following questions. Number 1, part A, answer is everything on the earth is made up of atoms. B, answer is protons, neutrons, and electrons. Number C, answer is the two kinds of electric charges are positive charge and negative charge. Part D, correct answer is it is produced by rubbing two materials. Part E, if a charged particle is brought close to a neutral object, it produces an opposite charge on it. This process is called electrostatic induction. Part F, a body can be tested for the presence of a charge by an instrument called a gold leaf electroscope. Part G, when clouds become highly charged due to rubbing against each other, a large number of electrons jump from one cloud to another or to the earth. This flow of electrons produces a flash of lightning. Part H, an electric circuit is a pathway along which charged particles can move. Part number I, materials that allow an electric charge to pass through them are called conductors, as in metals. Part J, a switch is a device that is used to turn a current on or off. When you turn the switch on, a small piece inside the switch completes the circuit and the current flows along the circuit. When you turn the switch off, the metal piece moves away from the wire and the current stops flowing. Now, question number 2, fill in the blanks. Part A, protons. Part B, positive. Part C, negative. D, loses. E, gains. F, static. G, repel. H, attract. I, lightning. J, rubbing. Question number 3, write attract or repel. A, repel. B, attract. C, attract. D, repel. Next, we have this picture. What is the name of given symbols and pictures? Bulb, battery, wire, conducted wires, crossing wires, and the switch. This is all for today. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.